A warm hello to everyone out there and thank you for joining us today. This presentation is going to take you to the Trinity College London Performance Arts 2020 syllabus. We will cover some general information on when candidates can enter for these exams, who the syllabus is for and the skills that are developed, what the syllabus has to offer, sample tasks at each level discussing what the requirements are and the expectations, extra support and information available to the candidates and teachers to help them prepare for these exams. Now let's talk about the launch details. The syllabus was launched on the 19th of September 2019. Candidates can be examined for the syllabus from the 1st of September 2020. There is no crossover period between the 2020 and the 2010 versions. The aim of the syllabus specifications is to encourage teachers and young people to use these qualifications as a stepping stone towards becoming confident, multi-skilled performers and articulate individuals. The syllabus is accessible and inclusive with an emphasis on the individual personality, interest and cultures and abilities. The syllabus has a clear objective at every grade, provides candidates with as much opportunity as possible to engage with the authentic performance and rehearsal experiences, provides clear guidance and signposting to support teachers and students when preparing for the exams. Now includes an initial level exam for solo performers, pairs and groups, which offers an invaluable early learning experience of the grades. So let's talk about what skills are developed. The exams assess the following skills through a range of context: performance, critical thinking and problem solving, planning and preparation, research and reflection, verbal and non-verbal communication, conversations and discussions, and interpersonal skills. The performance arts exams are designed for learners who want to explore the variety of performance arts available. These exams provide learners of all abilities to create and give performances that reflect their personality and culture. They may use performance skills they already have, working them into holistic performance, or they may use this qualification as an opportunity to learn new skills. It is the most inclusive of all performance syllabuses. The format of the exams allows learners and teachers to choose from a wide range of options, focusing on skills and material in which they have particular interest or that complement their studies. The exams are about creating and sustaining performances. They are about engaging and entertaining and developing a relationship with the audience, and in solo and pair exams, being able to articulate the candidate's understanding of the material and their skills used in the reflection with the examiner. This syllabus also recognizes the value of performance contributory skills, which are art forms in themselves. So, for example, a candidate might present a lighting plan or soundscape they have created, or demonstrate specific makeup or prop making techniques. The exams present candidates with practical, creative tasks that enable them to develop invaluable 21st century skills in confidence, creativity, and communication. Now let's talk about some examples of the performance art skills. Here's a list of performance and contributory skills that could be demonstrated in the exams. Know that these are just examples and candidates are free to explore and use performance skills not listed here. So, how is the performance arts different to the other drama exams and performance-based syllabuses of Trinity? In the first instance, the content of the program offered can be drawn from any performance arts form. Secondly, what Trinity is looking for is the way that the candidates have combined the skills and material to create a program that communicates meaning and which engages the audience. It is about offering a total performance experience. For example, in performing a piece of prose or poetry for the speech and drama syllabus, the candidate would be assessed on the use of their vocal and physical techniques to convey meaning. In the performance arts, the candidate will be additionally assessed on their fullest interpretation of the poem, or so that it might be that the candidate chooses to wear a costume that highlights a particular aspect of the piece they are reciting, or the part of the poem they may include some dance or singing. So the performance is assessed as a unified whole. In addition to these skills, we actively encourage candidates to include performance skills not assessed in the other performance syllabuses. For example, traditional and folk dances, a comedy routine, or tea making ceremony, or if choosing to sing as a part of the program, it could be a song that isn't a conventional musical. Candidates should embrace this performance opportunities that these exams provide. The exam requirements are laid out on the page with the assessment criteria and attainment descriptors alongside, so that the teacher and the candidates can clearly see what the candidate needs to do during the exam, the maximum marks awarded for each task, any considerations that need to be noted for each task. In the notes section, page references for the extra guidance on the task, what skills are being assessed, the level of skill needed to achieve the different pass levels. Each of the grades have clear assessment criteria and attainment descriptors, which provide insight for the teachers and candidates on the expectations and what the examiner is looking for at each level. As an example of a grade 2 performance task 1, candidates give a performance or performances which demonstrate two performance skills. So for example, they might perform a mime that includes magic tricks, or they might choose to perform the mime followed by a magic act. At this level, the skills and material do not have to be connected by a theme or story, although we would always encourage using a connecting element in the performance. At this level, the performance should show some creativity and developing technical proficiency for skills shown. They should also show a good level of understanding of the material and skills used and a consistent awareness of the audience. Now let's look at another example, grade 2 performance contributory skill task 2. The candidate has the option to either give another performance using a performance skill from task 1 or a different skill, or they could give a demonstration of the contributory skill. If the contributory skill option is chosen, then it should be in some way related to the performance of task 1. So for example, if the candidate was wearing makeup in a particular makeup design for the performance, then they should give a short demonstration as to how the makeup was applied, perhaps using another person as a model, or they could show with commentary and photographs to illustrate the different stages of the makeup application process. The commentary could include such information as to how the makeup was applied, what way the particular effect was achieved, and the ideas that led to the makeup design, as well as the application process. At this level, the contributory skill should show some evidence of preparation, some clear presentation skills, and understanding of the value of the contributory skill to the performance. At the intermediate level, the candidate should aim to give continuous, accurate, and imaginative performances that convey a narrative, character, mood, or theme. There should be some technical proficiency shown in the demonstration of the skills. At this level, the candidates should be showing evidence of careful preparation in their performance sequence and some creative choices made in its design. We use the term performance sequence because we are looking at how the candidate links the skills. In the discussion with the examiner, candidate should be able to reflect with confidence on their performances and the skills used. Let's look at an example from grade 5 performance task 1. The candidate performs a continuous performance sequence that demonstrates two performance skills. So, the candidate should be planning a sequence that moves seamlessly from skill to skill. At this level, they should be able to convey to the audience a clear connection in narrative, mood, character, or theme. What this means is that there should be a clear meaning in what the candidate performs. So, this encourages the candidate to think about why they are putting these particular skills together, what information do they want to convey to the audience. This can also be an opportunity for the candidates to think about the issues that are very important to them and how they might convey these through the performances that they create. So, for example, a candidate may perform a spoken word performance which merges into a mime routine which conveys the subject of pressures of social networking. Let's look at another example from grade 5, performance or contributory skill, task 2. As for the lower grades, the candidates has the option to give another performance, this time they're demonstrating two performance skills, one of which should be different to those demonstrated in task 1, or they could give a demonstration of a contributory skill. If the contributory skill option is chosen, then it should in some way be related to the performance of task 1. For example, in task 1, the candidate might have performed a song from the musical Hamilton that flows into a hip-hop dance sequence exploring honor and reputation. So, for the contributory skill, the candidate should demonstrate with the use of dance charts or even video footage on a laptop how they created the choreography for the hip-hop dance routine, clearly outlining the theme and the narrative thread. Ensure that there is a structure to the presentation, that it has a clear beginning, is in logical order, and there's a clear ending. Now let's look at the advanced grades expectations. From grade 6 to 8, candidates should be offering a performance sequence that show careful planning and presentation and preparation. Building on the intermediate grade levels, the performances should convey narrative, character, mood, or theme, and there should be some original choices made in the interpretations. The candidates should be able to engage their audience with authority, and technical proficiency should be shown in the demonstration of the skills. In the discussion with the examiner, the candidates should be able to reflect upon with confidence and in-depth understanding of their skills and performances and the skills that they have used. Let's look at an example from grade 7 performance task 1. The candidate gives a continuous performance sequence that demonstrates three performance skills. Similar to the intermediate grades, the candidates should be providing a performance that conveys to the audience a clear link through theme, narrative, mood, or character. Candidate can also perform part of the program with another performer. This provides the candidate with the opportunity to develop skills of communicating with and responding to another performer and developing a rapport with them. An example of a program might be an audio drama, a monologue recorded with extra sound effects. Then a magic act develops the sequence, the central character from the audio drama becomes the magician who continues the monologue using magic tricks to talk about who they really are, offering clues with each trick. Finally, the magician produces two puppets, and this final sequence is a scene between these two puppets which finally reveal the true identity of the protagonist. So here, there's a strong narrative link between the two performances. At this level, the design and realization of the performance should show imagination with some clear and persuasive choices of interpretation, and the skills should be demonstrated with technical proficiency and control. The candidate should show evidence, a clear understanding of material and the skills used should show ability to engage the audience with confidence. Now let's look at another example, grade 7, contributory skill, task 2. At this level, the contributory skill is compulsory, acknowledging its vital role in offering a technical or practical or theoretical perspective on performance sequence. There must be a relationship between task 2 and task 1. So, to use the example mentioned in task 1, in task 2, the candidate should give a demonstration on the technique of animating the puppets or making them or of how the sound effects were created. Their presentation should show substantial research and preparation of and be delivered with confidence in an engaging manner. At this level, the contributory skill should show the candidate's ability to convey ideas clearly and with imagination. There should be a clear rationale for their ideas and a secure understanding of the skills used. Now let's look at feedback, marks and certificates. The performance arts exams are solo candidates, pairs and groups. Solo and pair candidates receive individual feedback and marks and a certificate if they pass. All candidates entered in a group will receive one set of marks and feedback for the group as a whole, and each member of the group receives a certificate. Let's look at the performance certificates. For solo candidates who may not necessarily want a graded qualification, but who would welcome the experience offered within this option, there are performance certificates. We have devised these for those candidates who prefer to focus solely on preparing and delivering a program of performance work as a way to candidates to consolidate their performance skills at the end of each level before moving up to the next level. For those candidates who move through the grades quite quickly, and so therefore the performance certificates act as an extra step before moving up the next level. This is very useful for both for the candidates who require extra support in their learning and for those who are able to learn quickly. The Performance Arts syllabus has one more offering, the Performance Arts in Production. The Performance Arts in Production exams are designed to allow schools, colleges and theatre groups to offer an entire production for assessment and learners taking part in any role, including backstage and technical roles, or a part of production can be included. The examiner watches the production and writes a report on the production as a whole. Teachers can choose between two pathways depending on their style of production. Pathway 1, for productions where candidates are involved in backstage or technical support roles or front of house as well as performing on the stage. Or Pathway 2, for productions where the candidates are just performing. Now let's talk about exam guidance. As mentioned earlier, the layout of the revised syllabus aims to provide clear and supportive guidance for teachers, and the back pages of the syllabus specifications contain some supporting information for each type of task within the grade. Trinity website also contains a range of additional material to support teachers and students, including sample texts, tips on skills in general, which we hope will help candidates expand their skills outside of the exam room, and much more coming soon, including sample exam videos. The website will be regularly updated with new material. Thank you for listening in.